Hello, Olive, friends of mine. Today I want to talk to you about a technique which is called Verdaccio. It is a coloring technique with green and blue undertones under skin. So we talked about this at one time. Hamis, and I have been asked about that frequently after that. So today I was thinking, like, why not just show you what it actually means. Verdaccio comes from the Italian fresco painters of the early Renaissance. This technique is like based on the Verdaccio oil painting technique. Green is a complementary color to red, and therefore placing them on top of each other can make quite dynamic effects. So I'm just putting down a layer with green on this paper. This is just a toned tan paper from Paint-On. So this is just a multimedia paper. So putting down some green here, and I will put some blue on this white paper, like to use green as an undertone for a little bit warmer skin tones, and blue for the colder ones, because green is a little bit warmer than blue. And green tend to kill the intensity of the orange and pink in many of our flesh tones. So now I have blue and green. Hopefully you can see it, I just had to check. So I'm switching to another green color, taking a brownish. This is a burnt sienna, which is my darkest color, so I will just put that on top. In many sets you see that you actually get pencils like that are very orange. You get green, you get blue. And this is kind of why. And also, what you can do if your skin set don't have those nice skin colors that you would like, you can put a base layer of blue or green under it. So this is just a pinkish kind of red iron oxide tint, is it called? So this is, as you can see, quite a pink skin color. So I'm just putting it down. Blending that out very well. It, and why we do it is because it gives it more natural look, and it, the blue under makes it actually look like it's veins under the skin. And it's quite pretty. I prefer to be doing this technique on the toned paper, but because we usually have white paper in our coloring books, I wanted to show you this on the white paper as well. So what you do, you just build up these layers as you want them. I have done this both with pastels and pencils. Don't think I ever tried markers because markers tend to not, or probably you can. I have just never tested it. I'm putting some. This is a orange tint. I just also often find in skin. So this and skin is made by orange and pink. And that's why so many skin sets has pencils that actually comes with them. They are not pre-mixed, but they are there so you actually can mix your own skin color. You can actually see how pink this pink is on the outer edge here. Or hopefully you can. And this painting technique or coloring technique is also sometimes called for the dead painting. Because when you kind of paint the skin before the person comes to life. That and just have my, what is this? This is my burnt sienna tint for my highlighted area. And as this is just a multimedia paper, it's not really made for pastels. But then again, our is our coloring books. So when you see that, you actually will see the colors all the way through it. Then you can cover it up if you want to. And of course, depending on dark you want your skin, you just keep on adding layers. So, now you see that my green attempt here is quite more visible on the toned paper than my blue on the white. I can lift it or try actually to lift it up to show you that we have kind of veins in our skin, that it actually looks like it has veins underneath. So if you have skin tones and pencils that you find is way too orange or too yellow, you can add a green or a blue undertone to tone that down. Then you actually use the Verdaccio painting method. So yeah, like I said, this can also be done with pencils. So if you, or I think that you should all test out, just take some paper, project this and have a go. Just put on layers like you normally color skin, just that the first skin is blue or green, depending on how or what kind of value you want your skin, if or how cold you want it. Green, I think work best on medium color skin to dark, and the blue I find is the best on from medium dark skin down to really almost white. Or the lightest toned people there are, people like or that has a very little pigment, or you can just skip the skin or color half of it with skin and make it a dead person. Anyways, test it out, have some fun. On some paper that you just don't really care for, you don't have to test it out on your best or your nicest picture in your most expensive book. Just take some paper or a book that you don't really fancy that much and test it out. Have a go. If you mess it up, okay, so you made a dead girl or a dead boy, so what? But have some fun, do it. So that was me, and all for me, I mean, about the Verdaccio. I'm not Italian, so my pronunciation might be a little bit off, but you can read how you type it, and you can Google it and or read about it and watch some videos out there. It's very interesting, and those who really dust this like with oil painting, they really make masterpieces. It's amazing. So thank you everybody for watching, and I will see you all later. Take care. Bye.